to the Pally Box. Currently on the set filming a couple episodes for the upcoming VHL Season 11. I'm here to talk to you real quick and brief about my official disclaimer. It's quite easy. If you're easily offended, can't take a joke, one of those people that likes to cry themselves to sleep and get butthurt over someone else's opinion, this show isn't for you. If you can't take a joke, you have no sense of humor whatsoever, please don't watch my show. Again, this is not official League Arena opinions. Red names, orange names, blue names, whatever color they may be. VHL staff, commissioner staff, BOGs, VHLPA, and League Arena officials, the higher-ups, if you will, have never authorized any content whatsoever on my show. It's my opinion, based off the facts that I gather from my sources. Again, let me reiterate. If you can't take a joke, have no sense of humor, don't watch my show. Because I'm going to warn you, right now, it doesn't matter who you are, what team you play for, what your position is within the league or on the website. If you do something that I find offensive, funny, comical, idiotic, moronic, I'll make fun of you. I will poke fun at you. Whether it be satire, skits, hard-hitting topics, discussions, controversial questions, someone trying to sweep something under the rug and I don't like it, I will talk about it. I'll make fun of your team if they are picked to do well and you guys fall flat on your face. I'll make fun of you if you shoot your mouth off on the forums like an idiot and acting like an idiot. I'll make fun of you. If you break the rules, well, let's just ask Rated R Bad Boy what I did to him in Season 3. I will throw the book at you. I will crush you with it. I will bury you. Again, if you have a problem with that, don't watch my show. I know you're probably thinking, isn't that kind of crazy asking someone not to watch his show? I don't want to deal with it. If you can't take a joke and you don't know what a sense of humor is, I don't want to deal with you. So this is my disclaimer. You've been warned. Continuing to watch this show and future episodes, you're basically signing that e-waiver. You're signing on the dotted line that I understand that I might be made fun of, that my team might be made fun of. I will not complain, blah, 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 blah. This is for entertainment purposes. It's the only show, let me reiterate that, the only show where someone, like me, stands in front of a camera right here and does a talk show based on opinions. My opinions are backed up by facts. Facts that I dig up through my sources, and I will never name my sources on the air. It's a long-standing relationship I've had with my sources since, well, almost 3 calendar years. Our first episode in April of 2010. That's the way it's going to stay. If you have a problem with that, don't watch my show. It's for adult-minded people with adult senses of humor who can take a joke. There might be F-bombs every once in a while. I might swear. I might make fun of your team. I might make fun of your draft. Or the people you bidded on. Or the amount of money that you spent for players. Just the risk you take. Again, if you don't have a sense of humor, if that bothers you, don't watch this show. And for those loyal fans that want the entertainment, that want the old Penalty Box, we're back. Enjoy.
Good evening, hockey fans, and welcome to another episode of the Penalty Box with your host, Kalal Oakman. It's been a while since we've had a discussion, a talk, a show, whatever you want to call it. I know some of you are like, well, where the hell have you been? What have you been doing? Well, I've been working out some legal stuff with my lawyers, new network change, all that other shit. And I've been taking a look at them, surveying the field, so to speak. And my God, has League Arena changed. It's turned into a TOS factory. Seems like everybody's getting a TOS. Everybody a TOS. A TOS here, a TOS there. Everybody gets butthurt, file a complaint. This guy gets TOS. Some of them, granted, some of them are genuinely deserved. And others are pretty much, why? Dumb. Moronic. Stupid. You got douchebags making douchebag posts, and you got another guy who says they're being douchebags, and it's just like football. The guy that throws the last punch or the last shove is the one that gets flagged. And that's what happens. Anyways, I think it's ridiculous. Inconsistent is the word that comes to mind. Inconsistency. You have a set guidelines, or you would think you do. The VHL, they have the constitution that they should be following to the letter. Even they don't even do that. Or sometimes they try to do that, and they're told by other people that they can't. We'll get into that later in the show. First and foremost, now that the greetings are out of the way, I do want to acknowledge a couple people that have helped out and contributed to the Penalty Box and radio shows in the past. Duke fucking Wayne, for one. AHL Mastermind. He's done a lot of stuff for the AHL in the past. AHL Power Rankings, helped out on the radio show. Thought I'd give him a shout-out. He's kind of bitching about not getting a shout-out. So, Duke, you got your fucking shout-out. Now shut the fuck up. Another guy I'd like to give a little shout-out to is Dudley Do-Right. Yeah, I thought about interviewing Dudley Do-Right on this show, but then again, do you really want to watch 10 minutes of me snoring? Didn't think so. The guy puts everybody to sleep. He's Dr. Dudley Do-Right, insomniac professional. If you have insomnia, seek out Dudley. I guarantee you within 6 minutes you're going to be sleeping. In fact, he's the GM of the Winnipeg Jets. Did you see their bidding? Half the management team was sleeping, and they forgot that they had not enough cap left to get the last two players. Somebody was sleeping on the job. Were they listening to Dudley again? I'm just saying. But they got that figured out, I guess. I don't know. I don't know how you can forget what your cap is or how much money you spent, because the damn program shows you how much you have left and shows you how many spots you have left. But then again, someone probably fell asleep during that meeting. I blame you, Dudley. There's your shout out. I'd interview you, I really would, but I'm getting sleepy just thinking about it. So no, we're not gonna do that. Not yet. For this season on the Penalty Box, we do have another person who's going to be a beat reporter. I can give you more details in later shows. I'm still working out the fine details, and my lawyers are drafting up the paperwork for him to join the show. And, of course, we're going to start a new segment, obviously. We have the 2-Minute Miner, but we're going to have a new one. The Preposterous Statement of the Week, or of the episode, if you will. And there's a lot of contenders for this episode's Preposterous Statement. I think one takes the cake. I'm going to throw one out right away. Even though it's preposterous, I find it hilarious. Earlier during last season, right before the playoffs, somebody made a thread saying, faces of the VHL. Keyword, faces of the VHL. What's preposterous about that, you say? The nominees. Dalla, from Dallavision, nominated as faces of the VHL. Has anybody seen his face in any of his videos? Faces of the VHL. No one's ever seen what he looks like. In fact, I was the only one on this very show to show you any glimpse that he actually exists. If you remember, his hand went like this, fist pumped, when he was trying to do a wraparound goal and he's talking to Active in the party or something. It was pretty funny. Yeah, he's never been in front of the camera. He's always behind the camera. Bit of a coward, if you ask me. I love your show, Dallavision. I really do. You always be number two. Anyways, on to other and bigger fish to fry. Preposterous statements. That's one of them I just threw out right away. Even though it is preposterous, I threw it up. We'll get into the next one, the winner that takes the cake. And this one's straight from the top. This totally takes the cake. But it'll be in the 2-Minute Miner coming up shortly. You have a lot more stuff looking forward. You have a lot more to look forward to. More content, more stuff in the upcoming episodes of the Penalty Box. I'm going to break down the VHL like I did in the past, going all the way back to the very, very beginning, where it was straight for the jugular, no holds barred. I don't care who the hell you are, I'm going to talk about your team. You do something wrong, I'm going to talk about it. You do something stupid on the forums, I'm going to talk about it. You be a douchebag like UPS Wyatt, I'm going to talk about it. And it's about as much as I'm going to mention it, UPS Wyatt, I think he's a douche. Guy's a troll, if you ask me. He's one of those guys that are not necessarily troll status, but he's a troll status wannabe. Now, I gotta give props out to the main trolls on the VHL website. No bigger than Official Mark. He is officially the world's biggest troll. Gotta give him credit. He's good at what he does. Yeah. I no qualms with him or anybody else like that. If that's what you want to do, that's fine. But then you got some guy that likes just to agitate people, likes to make stupid posts with hidden agendas, flashy title, and a totally different context. Douchebaggery. Dumb. Absolutely stupid. But that's just me. Other people may like it and other people may enjoy it, but that's to each his own. Whatever floats your boat. Anyways, on to this week's show. Now, this episode, we have behind-the-scenes footage of a certain team's draft and how they botched it. And I'm not talking about the Winnipeg Jets. That's coming up later. Also, a two-minute minor that will bury all two-minute minors. Going back to the original two-minute minor when I was bitching about a goalie, shooting his mouth off. You're not going to believe what happened last season during the playoffs. And, ironically, it takes the cake for a preposterous statement of this episode. So you have that to look forward to. We'll see you right when we come back from this break. Don't go away. Jump right into the two-minute minor. Double standards. Double standards. You have a VHL constitution which the league and all players and management are supposed to follow to the letter. To the letter. You also have a TOS, a Terms of Service Agreement, within the website, of which it says you can't create a second account, can't play on second accounts, and all that stuff. Many people have been busted. Usually have been banned, TOS, whatever, and so forth, and so on, and so forth. There's been a black eye. Another black eye in the VHL. The first black eye was Season 6 Norfolk Admirals, but of course they didn't find out about it until Season 8. Well, not really a lot they could do. They just kind of swept it under the rug and hoped to God no one remembered. I remember. A lot of other people remember too. But this time they found out during the playoffs. They found out that a certain player on a certain team had two accounts. And also, on top of that, the cherry on the cake, he hasn't posted in his locker room at all. Now, according to Article 4, Rosters and Transactions in the VHL Constitution, Section 4, Section 4.1 of the RICO Decimo System, it reads, Blacklist Requirements. Now, I'm quoting it word for word. Look it up if you don't believe me. Subsection 4.1. Blacklist requirements. Owners, management may only blacklist a player for inactivity or conduct detrimental to their organization. Inactivity is defined as either 1. A player not showing up to scheduled games without contacting management for a period of 1 week. 2. A player missing scheduled games frequently. Or 3. A player not posting their availability for multiple weeks, 2 in a row. It also reads, league staff, site staff, have the ability to blacklist a player for multiple rule violations and inactivity. Let me rephrase that. Or, not rephrase it, but reiterate that word. Inactivity. It's in the Constitution. This can be done at their discretion with sufficient evidence. Now, evidence being that you look in the locker room, you see that he hasn't made a post all fucking season. Enough evidence for me, wouldn't you think? Yes. I'm not going to name names, Washington Capitals. They had a little issue in the playoffs. My sources are close to... I'm not going to name them. Don't even ask. Don't even think about asking me to name my sources. I won't. The facts are the facts. The facts are that this player had the same IP as a certain other player. Was on this team. Didn't post any availability in his thread for more than 2 weeks. They couldn't TOS him because it came straight from the top. That you couldn't. Just let it ride out. Sweep it under the rug. Let it go. Hopefully they get eliminated and all. No big deal. They went on to the next round. And then to the next round. And then to the next round. And finally they won the Stanley Cup. And then the league's like... Before they won the Stanley Cup, the commissioner's staff tried to blacklist them. Again, straight from the top. Can't blacklist them. Because if you blacklist this player for inactivity in his locker room, you're going to have to check all other locker rooms. Now, when I said preposterous statement winner, there it is right there. Preposterous statement winner number one. If you blacklist this player for inactivity in his locker room, you're going to have to check all other locker rooms for inactive players. Excuse me? This is coming from the same website and staff that said Call Me Nit in Season 9 could be blacklisted for inactivity when there's three other guys on this fucking team that were inactive and didn't post their availabilities. Double standard? Sweeping shit under the rug. What gives? It says in the rules, in the Constitution, that the league, that is, the commissioner's staff and the BOG, have the right, the power, to blacklist said player. It doesn't have to come from management. For inactivity. And yet you, the higher-ups, prevent them, tie their hands behind their back from doing their job, and then they go on to win the cup with an illegal roster? Yeah. And then you say, well, there's nothing you can do about it. Just sweeping under the rug. Reactive. I have a couple suggestions to fix this problem that we're having in the VHL. This problem that's been going a long time. Follow the frickin' rules. Follow the Constitution to the letter, regardless of who you are. If you hold your owners, your management, and your players to a higher standard, and you punish those who violate the flippin' rules, and you stick to your guns and make sure it sticks, this wouldn't happen. But now, because you are cowardly, sweep it under the rug, try to be all hush-hush and get behind closed doors, more people who have no life are gonna do everything they can to try and cheat just so they can satisfy and get some sort of gratification of being good at a video game. While all the others who follow the rules play straight up, get trampled on. And you're like, well, we gotta protect the players' rights. What about all those players that play by the rules? What about their rights that are being violated right now because of the certain few that choose to cheat? What about them? Who's fighting for them? The majority of the league follows the rules. The majority of the league, well, some people may say they're not the greatest players in the world, whether you're in the AHL, CHL, or NHL, the majority of you follow the rules. And your rights to fair play in a straight-up game is being violated by a select few. And those select few aren't being punished. It's being swept under the rug. It's being pushed aside. Never happened. It doesn't exist. Everything's all fine and dandy here. Everything's happy-go-lucky joy. No, it's not. You're screwing them over. I have a suggestion for you. It's real simple. Quit being reactive. Be proactive. Firm, hard, strict rules and enforce them with due diligence and a swift freaking ban hammer. Now, if you can't ban them, if you don't want people to use the word ban, if it's too taboo to say ban, I have another one for you. Suspend them from VHL play indefinitely. Suspend them. It's a suspension. They just can't play in the VHL. And anybody found aiding and abetting, anybody found knowing that they are on their team and they don't do anything about it, you suffer the same consequences. I say chop off their heads, put it on a post, virtually, of course, and put it on display for others. Do not follow in these douchebags' footsteps, or you will share their same fate. You crack down the hammer on a certain few, and you kind of let a couple others slide by the wayside. Enough's enough with the double standards. Pick one and stick with it. Seriously. Now, I'm not going to bring up the stats program. The stats program is a work in progress. It's only been a work in progress for 3 calendar years. and are taking steps to make it better, I give him that. It's better than nothing. But if you knew that League Daddy was crashing, and other people were giving you suggestions because League Daddy was crashing and didn't look like it was going to come back, and you swept them under the rug, League Daddy be back, League Daddy be fine, we're all good, happy-go-lucky. Yeah. What happened? Week 2 last season? Or, well, as some people have called it, beta season 3? It never came back. And you were caught with your pants down. And then you come out with this, the stats program's finally here! Bullshit. It looked like somebody scrambled and threw it together and puked it on a plate. I'm sorry. You've come a long way. It looks a lot better now than what it did. But let's be honest. Call a spade a spade. You were caught with your pants down. Why? Because you were reactive instead of proactive. Had you have been proactive, this wouldn't have happened. Listen to your members. Listen to the owners. Listen to the commissioner's staff and the members of the VHL community. When they tell you shit is going to happen, more likely that shit is going to happen. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. And if you sit around saying everything's all great, cuddly, lovable, like a Care Bear, things are so good now. Bullshit. And when the shit hits the fan, it really hits. You got caught with your pants down twice. My advice, quit micromanaging league staff. Quit micromanaging the VHL community. Either you jump in all the way into the deep end, or you stay out and let those whose job is to manage that league, let them manage the league. Let them do their job. If they see something's wrong with their league, let them handle it. Now, if it's a TOS issue, by all means, that's your domain. But if it's a VHL issue, such as gameplay or VHL constitution rule violation related, let them do their job and do not interfere. Don't. Otherwise, what's the use of having a VHL commissioner? What's the use of having VHL BOGs if you're just going to one-up them and say, no, you can't do that? Doesn't make any sense. It makes zero sense whatsoever. And the preposterous statement that, if you blacklist him, then you're going to have to check all the other locker rooms so you can blacklist those inactives. Where was that logic in Season 9? He called me Nit was being blacklisted. I don't know. Even 3 people on his own team did the same thing, and Call Me Nit never missed a single game. Not one game was missed. It was just that he failed the post in his locker room. And the book was thrown at him. Of course, now, don't get me wrong, Call Me Nit, after that judgment, after that whole ordeal was over, he kind of did something stupid, which made his situation worse. I'm not condoning that. I'm talking specifically for the blacklisting of Call Me Nit that led up to the other shenanigans that he was involved in. I'm not talking about those. I'm just talking about the blacklisting. Kind of stupid double standard, if you ask me. So stop with the double standards. Just stop. You know who I am. You know who I'm talking to. Just let them do their job. If you have other people willing to give you help, swallow the fucking bullet in your pride and allow them to help. Now, I know a lot of other things, you reached out with the community and have done this. Well, it only took you, the league staff, the ones that are reactive, to do something again stupid, in my opinion, and say, we're going to push everything to the front page. There's going to be no more use of the forums. That kind of drew an outrage. Site traffic was an all-time low until a brave soul made a post that was an eye-opener. A good post, by the way. And then all of a sudden, more traffic to the forums, back to normal. And you're like, we were never going to do that in the first place. Reactive. Once again, be proactive. Listen to the people on the front line. Listen to them when they tell you that something's wrong. Something smells fishy. Let them do their job. Unleash the dog. Let the dog hunt. And when the dog comes back with the prey in its mouth, give it praise. Don't throw it back in the kennel and sweep it under the rug. It's real simple. And that goes for you other douchebags who are in the league. Now, I'm calling you douchebags because you are. Those that want to cheat, you will be caught. It's just a matter of when, not if. And when you do get caught, I hope they ban your ass. The league doesn't need people like you. If you suck at life that much, and you suck at the game so much that you're willing to cheat at a video game just so you can make the precious playoffs, just so you can screw over 17 other people
on a different team for a playoff spot. You know who I'm talking about. Hello, Yager. Hey, how you doing? Luke LK, Rated R Bad Boy, and all the other ones that have recovered gamer tags and played other games. Ironically, a couple of them are management now. Stupid, I know. Just quit. Seriously, just leave. Go away. Why do you even have to try and cheat? I mean, here's the best part. Those that get caught, the ones that get banned, they automatically create a new account, make a post, screaming to the high heavens, bloody murder, that this league sucks, that the website sucks. I'm not saying the website sucks. I'm saying it has issues that can be fixed, and I'm trying to fix them. Other people may say I'm beating a dead horse. No, the horse is already dead. I'm trying to drag the horse off the road so we can move forward. Other people who've gotten banned come in, create a new account, make a post, crying, whining, this website sucks, this league sucks, the commissioner sucks, blah, 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 this all sucks, blah, 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 I'm never coming back here, and then you try to sneak back in. You look like a moron. You make a post saying how much the league sucks, but yet you try your damnedest to come back in and play. Then the league must not suck. Maybe you just have a hard time making friends. Or you have no life. You're pathetic. You know what I'm talking about. You've seen them. The people that make the posts after they quit. They rage quit. Or get banned. They make a new account. They come in. Scream bloody murder. Claim that the website sucks. Claim that the league sucks. It's pathetic. Its members are shitty. They can have better people in the EASHL. But yet they flock like moths to a flame. They continue to create new accounts and try to play and try to sneak in. You're pathetic. I find you amusing. Entertaining. I'm not going to name any names. I don't want to give you any more fame than you deserve. And you deserve about that much. Like, literally none. Zero. Anyways, it's been the 2-minute minor. Probably longer than 2 minutes. I've just quit being reactive. Be proactive. Unleash the dog and let the dog hunt. You have the Constitution. Follow the Constitution to the letter the way it's written. If you find foul shenanigans, whether it's in the playoffs or the regular seasons, stick to your guns. Follow the Constitution. No one's going to fault you for that. No one's going to say, oh, look, they're weak. And if people are going to, obviously people, especially the person that's going to be banned or broken the rules, he's automatically going to claim bias. Every single person does. As soon as something goes wrong and they're found guilty, the first thing out of their virtual mouth via keyboard, I was picked on, I was targeted, I was singled out. There's bias. They just don't like me for who I am, blah, 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 blah. So, let me ease your conscience. Every single person that's going to get busted from now until the end of days is going to say that. Once you accept that and acknowledge that, you don't have to worry about it ever again. It's not bias. You have the Constitution behind you. You have the rules on your side. If they violate the rules, I don't care who the hell they are or what position they're in. Rules are rules, and they shall be followed by all, not just some. Because if you think about it, if you're trying to protect a player's rights, that person that's cheating is violating everybody else's rights. So what do? Do you sweep it under the rug and hope to God no one notices? Or do you bite the small bullet for the greater good? You bite the small bullet for the greater good. We'll be right back after this message with that behind-the-scenes footage of a certain team's draft. Don't go. We have special footage of the Buffalo Sabres war room, if you will. Their draft. The night of the draft. Friday. Not bidding. Not Sunday. Friday. And the night before. It's shocking. And if you have children, make sure that they're not watching this show. And if you have children, why the hell are you watching this show with children on your lap? Shame on you. Didn't you learn your lesson?
Yeah. What's your ass? The bidding doesn't start till Sunday.
Sunday. No, I'm at work. Someone spilled. Come on.
Yeah, whatever. It's sort of just.
So that explains it. That's why Buffalo's two draft picks are missed picks. Kind of weird. It's too bad. I'm sure they could have drafted some talented people that could help their organization, but now I guess those draft picks are wasted. I guess the same thing happened on trade deadline night when Ottawa is trying to get a hold of Buffalo for a certain trade that involved another team, and, well, let's just say Ottawa and another team couldn't get a hold of Buffalo. They got a hold of the management, and the management's like, oh, where's that? You know, Tino's hasn't been online. We have no idea. We don't know what's going on. Communication. Work on your communication. Things like this won't happen. As long as you get everybody up to speed, everybody in your organization should. Top to bottom, NHL GMs, AHL GMs, CHL GMs should be in constant communication with the ownership. It's a well-run team. And if you don't, shit like that happens. And that concludes this episode of the Penalty Box. And for those of you who might get butthurt, too bad. Don't care. I warned you in the very beginning. You were warned. Nobody's safe. Nobody is above the ire of the Penalty Box. You do something stupid, I'll call you out for it. You make an ass of yourself, I'll call you out for it. You make a preposterous statement on the forums, I'll call you out for it. Pretty much everybody's fair game. Everybody's fair game. And I can take the criticism. If you don't like my show, that's fine. I don't care. No problem. For those hardcore fans, I appreciate it. A lot of messages over the past seasons. Thank you very much. I do this because you guys are awesome. Duke fucking Wayne, Dudley Do-Right, Parise, Biohizzle, the very first fan. He watched the very first show, the first viewer, whose curse is finally broken. He was touched the playoffs in season 9. Congratulations, Bio. A lot of people. McKenna's, Tiny, STB the Tiny. Of course, my arch nemesis, the guy I absolutely hate. I say that with a smile on my face because he knows what I'm talking about. The Dos Pesos, $2. Yeah. Can't wait for the next episode. And then there's B. McDonald. Oh, I forgot to mention. B. McDonald, current commissioner, wanted me to mention something. I forget the guy's name that was recently banned, but when he was banned, I believe Haji put this in the chat box. Hashtag get owned. I told him I'd say it. There you go, Brody. That's all we have from the Penalty Box Studios. I'm Kalal Open. Thank you for watching, and we will see you at Center Ice when the puck drops March 3rd. Don't go anywhere.